how do we change? How do we create this new society that I believe a lot of people haven't given up hope? They still believe in it. But we're finding out just how hard it is to change.
We are living in an important time of great changes in the earth today. We can choose to experience it as a time of destruction or as a time of rebirth. The power lies in how we perceive our reality. Most importantly, in remembering how we created it in the first place. But first, we need to look within.
The future is becoming clearer and clearer. We need to look at new ways of thinking, new paradigms and new belief structures that might in fact be better solutions than just relying on scientific technologies to create the problems without changing the consciousness that created the problems to begin with.
When we're starting to ask where we are going, then we begin the quest. The root word of the word question is quest. And so as we begin with our questions, we are actually in a journey to discover what could be possible from the world that we are used to, or the world that's no longer working for us right now.
Coming into the Maya experience, you're coming from your everyday life, from everyday situations and scenarios, and you kind of come in with the same frame of mind, a little bit anxious in the mind, a little bit anxious in the body, always trying to go, go, go. But coming away from the whole experience now with the coconut fast, I found that everything is much more clear. You know, my mind went from trying to deal with everyday wants and needs to just starting to relax. As you do the fast, your body starts to relax a little bit more, starts to repair itself.
Sometimes it's good to, feel that it's just you. You're one with nature, you're one with yourself. And fasting just on coconuts, gives you that clarity that you're looking for.
One of the biggest problems in the world isn't really overpopulation, because a lot of people don't really consume that much. But maybe it's about feeling like we need so much in order to thrive and be happy. So here in our spaces, there are these processes that help people to transition into moving away from this idea that more is more. There is this insight that actually less is more.
Many times when people come here the first time into the spaces, they are sharing the same question. And the question is, how can I start to be more simple? And the answer here in Maya and by Gallipal to the question is fasting. So fasting is our tool to transition from the old into the new.
Once I started on the raw food diet, a week into it, I wanted to experience the fasting experience. My first experience with fasting was on the coconut day. And to my surprise, I guess because my body had so many nutrients from the, fresh vegetables and everything, I didn't really notice my hunger. I wasn't that hungry. And that was surprising to me, because usually in a normal day, I would have consumed so many different foods. So it was kind of shocking, and it made me slow down and think, okay, maybe everything that I consume in my body is not necessary.
We're basically finding out that becoming simple isn't really that easy. when you look at our relationship with food, for example, science has known it for quite a while that the more stressed you are, the more tense your body is, we tend to become more acidic. Our bodies create more acid in our system, and this is one of the reasons why we're eating so much.
The first thing what the body really does during a fast is breaking down damaged cells and toxic tissues. So this is when the autolysis starts to happen. The autolysis, you can say, like, it's a self-digestion. So literally, the body is digesting the old you to create new space for the new you. Because really, every tissue in your body is storage of memories. One of the main things what people realize here is that fasting is not really about eating nothing. Fasting is really like a lifestyle. So it's a lifestyle where you have the ability to say stop, to slow down in any situation.
How do we adapt our lifestyle to become resilient to the changes we are facing today? I had to ask this myself after working in a climate change related disaster. For the last 10 years, I've worked with different change systems, and I've witnessed how much of our solutions can no longer adapt to the increasing vulnerability we are facing. We can no longer solve the crisis the same way we have done so before. I'm looking at the eco-village model because it teaches us to live and practice a way of life that's independent of external resources.
Now that we're looking at the possibility that we don't actually need to consume so much, in Maya, sometimes when people are living on a coconut diet, maybe it's a day. Sometimes I've seen and watched people who have lived on almost nothing but coconuts for 6 months. Can you imagine it? Their carbon footprint is almost zero.
But you need just a little. You already have all, so you just need a little from this one, a little from this one. You don't have to need to get all, everything. You just have to feel that everything is enough. No, it's just enough. You have to have this contentment. The nature here can help you to realize where is peace. That's it. That's what Maya gives to people.
Get here where I am right now to have this simple life and to feel life every day with joy and happiness and love. It's like, I mean, you don't have to go through any process, you just have to be in a little contact step by step with the nature, and that's how you feel your heart. And you don't think, you it's just like your focus, it's not your mind anymore, but you start to listen your heart. Like, in the nature, you can really feel.
It's happening now, within me and you, within us, the view of ourselves, of the old systems that no longer serve humanity nor the planet as a whole. The It was always hope. And now there's a choice. That together we can have our harmony back. An inner climate change to remember that the earth is our body and our body is the earth. And what we do to ourselves, we're doing to her.